Authorities in Tampa had a tip. Joshua Haken, his wife Sharon, and their boys were in Cuba. They were right. CNN's Patrick Ottman found them on their sailboat, the Salty, at the Hemingway Marina outside Havana.
Sort of driving around, I didn't see any unusual presence of security. It seemed like just a beautiful day. Lots of boats, including boats from the United States. And then we get to the last slip, and sure enough, I see the name there, Salty. I see the paw prints on the side.
Ottman saw one of the boys playing on the deck. He spoke only briefly with Haken and his wife before Cuban authorities escorted him from the dock. In Tampa, police had known they were dealing with a man who could pull this off.
We've said all along that, you know, making irrational decisions doesn't always make you unintelligent. I mean, we know he's a very intelligent individual. He's an engineer.
Last Wednesday, the family pickup truck was found in Madeira Beach, not far from St. Petersburg. Surveillance video showed Haken and his wife Sharon at a dock preparing a sailboat. That same day, authorities say Haken kidnapped his children, Chase and Cole, from the maternal grandparents' home. Patricia Hauser called 911.
911, what is your emergency?
Yes, my son-in-law just kidnapped my two grandchildren. They've been in my state custody.
It's not clear how Haken and his wife knew where they were. Just last week, back home in Louisiana, the Hakens lost their parental rights. The saga began last year. Police in Slidell, responding to a disturbance at a hotel, say they found weapons and drugs in the Hakens' room. The children were there with them. Police say the Hakens were talking strangely about a, quote, journey to the Armageddon. The children were taken and put in foster care out of concern for their safety. According to Louisiana authorities, Haken showed up at the foster home with a gun demanding his kids. He ran off when 911 was called. At some point, the boys were sent to their grandparents. Now, what will Cuba do? The State Department says it is in touch with Cuban officials.
We are aware of this case, and the U.S. Interest Section is in contact with local authorities. U.S. officials are providing all appropriate assistance to the family.
An extradition treaty between the U.S. and Cuba has not been enforced in years. But in recent times, the two countries have successfully negotiated the return of wanted individuals. The FBI still lists 70 fugitives living there. The question, how will the Cubans treat the case of the Hakens?
Well, now we know how the Cubans are treating the case with the Hakens with that breaking news from Patrick Ottman out of Havana, Wolf. And, you know, we do not believe that Haken had any ties to Cuba, but clearly he must have thought that there was a chance that they would not send him back to the United States. It was clearly a miscalculation. Wolf?
And we'll see when the Cubans, in fact, do return these individuals to the United States. They say they will do it. That's the breaking news. That would be a significant gesture on the part of the Cuban government in Havana.